Properties here. There's Oak Grove, Kellerman. This is northeast Tuscaloosa County. And again, there's your couplet. Now, this is probably in this region right now. And it's been confirmed damage out here. But again, I can't tell you enough to take this thing seriously. And again, understand this tornado is probably in this region right now.
Just a loud ripping noise.
Glass was flying and metal, could hear sheet metal flying.
The garage door was bowing in when we were trying to get in this little cubbyhole.
There's some folks in there and they hurt pretty bad.
Our neighbors, most of their houses are a total loss, and we just mainly have minimal damage to our house.
Have these houses already been searched?
There's a number of streets that we are unable to get down due to wires being down, due to trees blocking our paths, but there has been heavy devastation in our community. It's no real way to assess the seriousness and the amount of damages until we get some daylight hours.
In the day, you can just see more of what happened and all, and tell the devastation. It was just really hard to tell last night.
And we've got some cuts and bruises, but I've talked to several people this morning, and everybody's got good spirits, and we're just thankful to be alive. I'm looking forward to Easter morning when we can start over again.
We can rebuild, and it's going to all work out.
We just kept holding each other. That's all we could do.
The pressure was so great, it just like your eardrums was about to burst. And then all of a sudden, the whole house started rumbling and shaking. It lasted probably a minute or a minute and a half, and it was gone.
A lot of debris started hitting the house, and when it started hitting the house, that's when I know the roof was coming on me. And then I heard whoop, whoop, and that was it. It was all over.
Just was a weird sound and stuff, and really, it was lightning. It was lightning so much you really thought like the moon was out or something, because it was just continuous lightning.
The wind force and that noise that I will never forget as long as I live, where it felt like it was pushing my house down into the bathroom and the tub. I was just cuddled down in praying for my life, and then hearing like windows and glass breaking. And nobody around, you know, you don't know whether everybody's dead or hurt or what, and then you're scared to come out because you don't know whether it's over with.
The entire United States of America will stand with these families and these communities that have been hit by the terrible tornado. And we're going to not only reach out to you, not only hold you in our thoughts and prayers, we're also going to do everything possible to make sure that the relief efforts are well coordinated and that everything that can possibly be done will be done.
We're looking at what remains of one of the deadliest tornadoes in Alabama's history, one of the most powerful tornadoes ever recorded in the United States. The book of Isaiah has a verse that has particular meaning to me. I'll just leave it with you. You were wearied with the length of your way, but you did not say it was hopeless. You found new life for your strength, and so you were not faint. My friends, the road to recovery is long. Your grief and your pain are profound. It will take weeks, months, even years to rebuild all that has been destroyed. But the process of restoration has begun. Because the most important thing you have, your spirit, was not destroyed.
You know, I just want to just thank the Lord that He spared my family. My family was at our neighbor's house, and it blew the roof off the house they was in. But there wasn't none of them harmed. They're safe, and you know, that's the main thing.